Hello everyone, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to simulate the interview screening system. In this tutorial, I'm going to store some applicant information in the form of a dictionary, and then I will loop over the dictionary to compare the applicant experience with your required experience. So what is your required experience? I need the number of years of experience of the applicant should be at least 4 years, and at the same time, he or she has to satisfy one of the following conditions. Either he or she knows Python and Java at the same time, or he or she has already got some project supervision experience. So let's see how we implement it. Suppose we have a lot of applicants, and we are going to store the applicants in the form of a dictionary. Applicants text equals a dictionary. And in this dictionary, I have 5 applicants. Anna as my first applicant. She has 2 years of experience. She knows the following languages. She knows 4 languages, and I put those 4 languages in a list. So I have a list in a dictionary. A list here in this dictionary. Okay. And Anna has no project supervision experience. When I finish one key value pair, I have to add the comma, and then I can put another key value pair. The other applicant is Ben. Let me use the copy and paste action to facilitate my data input. He has 5 years of experience rather than 2, and the languages he knows is like this. And again, Ben has no project supervision experience. How about the third applicant? Kelvin. He has 3 years of experience. He knows other languages. And he has project supervision experience. How about the fourth applicant? She is Dorothy. She has 6 years of experience. She knows other languages. And she has no project supervision experience. How about the final applicant, Esther? She has 4 years of experience. She knows other languages. and she has project experience already. So when we have these pieces of information, how can I screen those eligible candidates? We have to set up the requirements first. We need at least 4 years of experience. We need the applicants to know Python and Java. With this given dictionary, we can do something like this. Name refers to the key which is storing the name of the candidates, and CV dict refers to the value part of the big dictionary, which is this small dictionary that stores the resume of each applicant. Okay. I want to loop over each of the candidates and the CV for each applicant. If the experience provided by the applicants is larger than or equal to the minimum experience here, and at the same time, excuse me, okay. Let me explain this whole part first. Required languages set. Here I want to change the list into a set. Okay. After I've changed the list into a set, I can do the set comparison. I require that the applicant should know both Python and Java. So Python and Java should both appear in the languages component of the CV. So I can use its subset command. Before I have to use the its subset command, I have to change the CV dict languages part to set first so that I can compare two sets in order to check whether both Python and Java are included in the languages value. I have to use this command to do so. Remember that we have to also set consider the project supervision experience, so I have to type the rest. Since the project supervision value is a Boolean value, if I do something like this here, the value would be either true or false. So I don't really need to say that it has to be equal to true, because I already used the Boolean values as my value in the key value pair. Then I can print out who are able to satisfy all my requirements. When we look back to the requirement slide, we have to see, we have to say that this opening bracket and closing bracket are necessary. We cannot ignore these two brackets. Otherwise, these two things will be operated first, because and will have a higher operator precedence than OR. If we want to really do the OR part first, we have to add the brackets to make sure that before handling the AND condition, the OR condition is treated first. Okay. After we have treated the OR condition, we will combine this result with the first part with an AND operator. If we forget to put the opening bracket and closing and the closing bracket here, this one and this one will be compared first. Okay, and this part, I mean the OR part at the end, will be performed after these two conditions are met. Okay. So that's why we have really have to use the brackets in order to satisfy our requirements listed on the slide. So let us see the result. Oh, there's an error. Where is it? Line 26. Oh, a typo. I'll run it. Only Dorothy and Esther can pass the screening. We can see the reason why. Anna has only 2 years of experience, so this part already fails. And when this part fails, the rest of the comparison will not be done because of the short-circuiting property of Python. And how about Ben? Ben has 5 years of experience. It seems to be okay, but how about the other things? Oh, he doesn't know both Python and Java. How about the project supervision experience? Oh, no experience. So this part is false, or this part is also false. It means that false or false returns false. So even though he has enough experience, we can't let Ben pass the screening. How about Calvin? Calvin has 3 years of experience, so he already fails the first part. But excuse me, by the short-circuiting property of Python, the whole condition will fail. And let us see Dorothy. Dorothy has 6 years of experience. Oh, pretty good. And how about the languages? Oh, this part is the subset of this part. So the language condition is satisfied. Even though she doesn't have project supervision experience, we can let Dorothy pass the screening, because we have a true and bracket true or false, we will still get true. Okay. And for Esther, she has 4 years of experience, and she just knows Java but not Python. So this part fails. But how about the project supervision experience? Yes, she has some experience in supervision. So we have true and false or true. False or true gives us true. So true and true. And here Esther can pass the screening. My code is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the best solution to the problem. If you can suggest any idea to improve my code, feel free to post your improvement on the comment section below the video. If you liked this video, please give me a like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.